Hi guys, it's HoppingHammy, and it has been so long since I've posted a video on this channel. I think it's been close to 11 months, which I'm so sorry. I just have not had any motivation or inspiration to post on this channel. I have been posting on my second channel though, but just not on this one. So I wanted to make a nice long video for you guys today to watch, to answer some questions that you had about different topics on Instagram. Like, you know, am I getting another hamster? What did I do with Kashi's cage, which you can kind of see behind me? I'm going to show you a tour of that, first of all, and then maybe show you some organization, some supplies organization that I have worked on the past few weeks. And I don't know, whatever else I can think to put in here. So I'm going to put some timestamps in a pinned comment below that if you want to watch a particular thing, you can click that and skip forward to it, and that way you don't have to get bored and watch my whole video if you don't feel like it. But if you do, since it's been so long, you can certainly listen to the whole video, and I would appreciate that very much. But I'm gonna go ahead and get started, and I hope you guys have fun watching this. I'm super nervous because it's been so long, but I'm gonna do my best here. I'm really excited to catch up with you guys.
So one of the main questions that people have been asking is what I did with Kashi's cage and if it's still a hamster cage and all of that. So I'm going to answer that question first. So after Kashi had passed away, I think I waited about a month or two until I cleaned it out, because I never feel ready to just clean it immediately. But after I cleaned it, it was all empty, and I felt weird about setting it up as a hamster cage with a wheel and water bottle and everything when I had no plans to get a hamster right away. So I came up with the idea to make a Zen garden, and I wanted something that would bring some of nature inside my office and just be really relaxing to look at. So I'm going to give you guys a little tour of that right now and just show you what all is inside. So I'm just going to start at the top here and pan down for you to see. This is what the Zen garden area looks like. And you can see I still have the tank set up the exact same, the two on the top and then this larger DIY one on the bottom. But I wanted to put it to use and make something really pretty out of it, because I didn't want you guys to think, oh, you know, you built this really nice cage and it's just sitting there going to waste. But it's not. It's being used and I'm really enjoying it, and it will be for a hamster cage again in future someday. But I'm going to start on the bottom here, and I'll just show you really briefly. I won't get too much into detail, because if you guys are interested, I could post more of a detailed Zen garden tour. But those lights in the corner there, those are definitely my favorite feature of the whole thing. They're really nice at night, especially because it's like a night light. And I'm just going to move my way across here. In the middle, I have a water fountain. And it's not too noisy, it just makes a little bit of a trickle noise, but I found this at Kohl's about a year ago. And like I said, it's not too noisy because I didn't want anything that sounded too much, like somebody was going to the bathroom or something. So it's just a soft drip noise, and it's really pretty. So the base that I'm using in here is sand. It took me quite a few bags of 50-pound sand to fill about 2 inches worth for the bottom of this cage. And it is all symmetrical, because you guys know how much I like things to be symmetrical, so it had to be like matching on both sides. I also have a few items that I had used in Kashi's cage, such as those rocks that are over here against the fence. Let's see what else. Oh, this wood platform, I used to put her food in that, and it was flipped upside down, and I put some plants in it this time. And then I also have a polyresin bridge in the back. If you remember, I had used that in her avatar cage theme. There's a terracotta pot in the front that I used in her desert cage theme. So there are sprinkles of Kashi here and there to remind me of her, and it makes me really happy, but I just didn't want to set it up as a hamster cage yet. So then there's also some wind chimes up top here that are really nice. And let's see what else. I guess that's pretty much it for the bottom down here. And then up top, I have some battery-operated candles that I can just turn on with a remote. There's also this lantern in the middle, which makes a wonderful nightlight. and that's battery operated as well. And then in the background here, this cork tree you see, you guys will remember from Kashi's cage. And I didn't want to have to store it because it is so big, and I decided I would make like a flowering tree in the middle here, and the flowers just go along the back of the tank. So I really like that feature. There's a plant on my speaker over here, another plant in the corner, and these leaf dishes, which serve no purpose, but they look nice. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And like I said, if you guys want to see more in detail or have me explain about different things, I don't know, just let me know and maybe I can do that as my next video. So I hope you guys enjoyed that little tour.
Okay, so Simply Munchkin asked, what's something you miss about having hamsters and what is something you don't miss? This is a really good question. So I definitely miss the companionship and the enjoyment of taking care of a fuzzy, cute little animal. I really love having kind of like a purpose, I guess, like every day you get to take care of something and you get to watch them blossom and get to see their personality emerge. I miss all of that so much. I even miss like the nighttime routine of feeding them and cleaning up the wheel and that sort of thing. It's just really fun. But the thing that I will say I don't miss, which is one of the reasons why I'm waiting on getting a hamster until I feel like I'm completely ready, is I did deal with a lot of anxiety when I had hamsters for the past many years, and it really was triggered when Yodel and Strudel had passed away within a day of each other. And since that point, I kind of was like always on edge, feeling like one of my hamsters might pass away. I felt like I could never relax. You know, if they came out during the day, I was like, oh no, does that mean that they're like sick or something? And with Kashi, I dealt with it probably the worst, which I don't think I ever told you guys I was dealing with anxiety. But it was mainly focused around the room temperature. Like, the way that my room is set up, it's really warm for the first part of the day, and then it gets really cold in the second part of the day. So it's like I have to be here to kind of monitor the temperature, to close the air vent, to open the air vent. And it's really stressful when I was going out all day to do something, and like I'd call somebody at home and have them check on the temperature, and they'd say, oh, it's, you know, 66 degrees in your room. And I like panicked because I was like, oh, that's freezing, and you know, we gotta warm it up. And just so it was this whole thing for me, you guys. I wasn't even sleeping well at night. I was getting up constantly to check on her, and I don't miss that part about having hamsters. And I feel like that's something that I'm probably always gonna deal with to a certain extent. I try to manage it the best that I can. But it is something that takes a bit of the enjoyment out of having hamsters. I'm curious if you guys have ever dealt with that type of thing with having pets. Maybe you can relate to this. It's like you care so much about them that it's almost overboard. You care too much. Like, you just can't relax. So yeah, hopefully that answers your question. I'm starting to ramble now. So a comment that Destiny left is, she said, I want to see a video of how you made the big cage. I am so sorry, you guys. I never got around to doing that video. When we built it, I had filmed for it. I had written down all my kind of instructions. I'm not a tutorial type of person, but I had planned to do that, and just that was when my health was really going downhill, and I just never got around to doing it. I'm so sorry, you guys. And I feel like now I completely have forgot how we even did it. That was something I had planned to do. I just never got to. Okay, let me find another comment here. It might be a bit late, but I'd like to know what you've been up to on your break. So, one of the things I already showed you guys, I worked on making the Zen garden behind me, and I worked on redecorating sort of my office. Like, I haven't changed it around or anything, but I added a lot of plants. I just made it a really peaceful place to be, and I will be pulling out my movie theater decorations again at some point, but I just felt like having a change, so that's something I did. I also have been working on singing practice. I've never sang in my life before, and I've really wanted to record some covers for my second channel. So I recorded Into the Unknown from Frozen 2, made a music video to go with that. That took me a month. And then I did All Is Found. That took me another month to make. And I've been doing some ballet practice. I've been really focusing on my health, just de-stressing, resting, allowing myself to heal. I've been dealing with, it's essentially like chronic fatigue. It's just fatigue all the time, and it affects me in a lot of different ways, brain fog and a bunch of things, but I've been focusing on improving my health in that sense and getting better so that I can live a more normal life and not feel tired all the time. So I guess that was kind of a long-winded answer, but yeah, that's what I've been up to. Okay, so multiple people asked me this question, so I won't put one username with it, but are you planning on getting a new hamster? So I do want to have another hamster again in future. You guys know I love hamsters. They're like the perfect pet for me. But as of now, I don't have a plan to get a hamster in the near future. Again, that could change. Like, it's funny, there's certain days where I think, you know, oh, it's gonna be a long time till I have a hamster, but then there's a day that comes up and I'm just like missing them so much, and I'm like, I could so easily go to a shelter, and if there's a hamster for adoption, I could just so easily take them home, you know, because, like, I don't know. So basically, I don't know. I don't know when I will get another hamster, but yes, in future, I definitely would like to adopt again because hamsters are awesome. Okay, so this is a really good question that Collie's Pets asked. She said, one thing I've been interested in learning is whether you'd like to get another hamster, which I think I already answered that, or perhaps even a different animal. So one thing you guys might not know is that I've really been getting back into considering having a dog again the past year or so. And I had a dachshund in past named Tootsie Roll, and she was so cute, and she had her quirks about it, but that's why I love her so much, because she was just like this really stubborn yet loving dog. So she had passed away. She was 12 and a half. She had Cushing's disease, and that was the hardest thing I've ever gone through, I think, in my life, was having to say goodbye to her and have her cremated and all of that. So I promised myself, I'm like, I'm never getting another dog. I never want to go through that pain again. But lately, I've been kind of considering getting a small dog again. I don't know if it'd be another dachshund, or I'm considering like a chihuahua. I'm considering getting an older dog from a shelter. I love older animals, and it's also a little bit less of a commitment. Like, it's not a 14-year commitment versus if you get a dog that's already older, it's maybe just like a 6-year commitment or something. So I don't know, but yeah, I am considering it. Something I've actually been considering as well is using my giant hamster cage behind me as like a dog enclosure. I would take the plexiglass off the front, put like a solid wall with a little door that opens, and use that as the area to put the dog's crate and water bottle, water dish, food dish, maybe a pan with like puppy pads that they can go pee. That way, if I'm out all day, it's a small dog, obviously, you know, they'll have like a nice area to walk around. I don't have to worry about them getting into anything. And I just think it'd be a really cool like dog enclosure, dog playpen type of thing. So that is something that I'm considering. And then I would use the top two tanks to put a dwarf hamster in. I'm thinking I wouldn't use them probably for a Syrian, but probably for a dwarf. So that's definitely something that I have considered, yes. As far as any other animals, I have no interest in other animals except for possibly a fish or snails or something really basic like that, I guess. I mean, fish aren't basic to take care of, I know, because my friend has some and she's been telling me a bit about it, and it sounds like a lot of work, but I just mean more basic, like not like a dog, a cat, like, you know, that type of thing. So yeah, those are the only other types of like animals I'm kind of interested in at this point, other than hamsters, a dog, and maybe something aquatic. So this is another hamster care related question that Astro and Amy Hamsters Care asked about. She'd like to see a video about ideal care rather than a bare minimum cage. We see so much about what the smallest cage is and how you can have the least things you can buy for a hamster. I think it would be cool to have a series that explains ideal care. That does sound really interesting. It sounds like a lot of work as well. I have to say I feel a little overwhelmed at the thought of trying to make that type of video, but maybe you could suggest that to Victoria Rachel, because I know she does those types of videos, and I think she'd be really good at explaining that type of question too. So I probably won't be able to get to it, but I do thank you for asking the question anyway, and if I ever am able to do that in future, I will try to. So here's more of a personal question. They said, this is from Shiny Happy Hamster, and they asked, how are you doing? Is your mental health improving? How is your dancing? My mental health is fine. Thankfully, I haven't been struggling with that. I know this year, 2020, has been really weird, and I know it's been affecting a lot of people. Thankfully, it hasn't affected me negatively. I'm doing fine, and I'm mainly just focusing, like I said before, on my physical health, trying to improve that. My physical health is linked kind of to my mental health, so on days that I don't feel that great, then I tend to feel more, you know, sad and stuff, just because I don't feel that great, but I'm doing fine in that sense. Thank you for asking. My dancing is going well. If you guys follow my second account, I recently got a new ballet floor because I never had an actual floor before. It was just a piece of fabric that I couldn't really dance on, so I'm wanting to start doing some at-home bar classes and practicing and just trying to get my body a little bit, not more in shape, but just like have some sort of exercise in my life, because I've just literally been sitting in a chair for like the past 5 years doing nothing. So this is something I'm able to do at home. I'm able to, you know, go my own pace, not push myself, not tire myself out. Sorry, my phone is ringing. Hold on. Can you make a full cage clean out and setup video of your massive DIY cage? I'm trying to get into cage themes. Can you make a how to put together a cage theme video? So I do have two, I think, how to put together a cage theme video on my channel where I give some tips, and I have a lot of cage themes. I have so many cage themes that are all in a playlist on my channel. And right now I don't have any plans to ruin my garden behind me until I were to get another hamster and decide to, you know, change that out. So unfortunately at the moment I'm not able to film a new cage theme video, but I will say one of the ones that I really wanted to do in past that I never got to was a Zen garden for hamster cages. So that kind of inspired this, but obviously the setup behind me is not hamster safe. It has like stuff in it that I wouldn't put with a hamster, like fake plants, for example, that, you know, my hamsters would have likely tried to eat it. So I will probably do cage themes again in future if I get a hamster, but they're going to be all like natural themes because that's kind of what I've gotten into recently.
Okay, so I have two more questions left that I'm going to answer, but I'm going to take a quick intermission here and show you guys some of my hamster supplies that I went through recently, and then I'll go back to the last two questions. So I'm going to start off by showing you guys these blue bins I have. I went through these tubs recently and I did decide to give away some items that were like some plastic and ceramic things that I just don't plan on using anymore because I prefer to use natural things. Thought I'd give it to a shelter that was local. I gave a couple of cages away as well. That way other people can use it and it's not just taking up space in my house. So I did keep everything that I got in like trade packages or from friends. Stuff like that has special memories to me, so I didn't give any of that away, but I just gave stuff away that I found at Goodwill for like 25 cents or whatever. So in this first bin here, this one I'm using to store my various types of little chews and like these wicker toys. There's some of these mineral chews. There's a lot of stuff in here. It's kind of all piled in, but at the moment I'm not setting up cage themes, so I just wanted to try to consolidate everything in the space as much as possible. I still have some seasonal items like Easter and that sort of thing, so this all fits in one tub, which is really nice. So I'll show you guys what is in the next tub now. Okay, so in this next tub, I have some similar things. I think a few more chews that didn't fit, and I also have my oat and my wheat sprays in this. I have this huge grass mat that I never was able to use with Kashi, but I'm definitely wanting to use it in future. Like I said, I have some of these like wheat and oat sprays, some of this nesting confetti, A lot of natural things as well that I have in here that I had used in Kashi's cage. Well, I mean, not the ones I had used in Kashi's cage. I just mean like the products I had used. So yeah, I have a bunch of stuff in there. That's all going to be kept for cages I set up in future. Then I have this one, which is mostly a few little plastic things I decided to keep. Like, for example, Chocolate Colors 26, I think it was, had sent me this card. And it is so adorable, you guys. Like, I use it in photo shoots for little dwarf hamsters, so I could not part with that. This was also like something else I had found at another pet store that I just have good memories of. So there's a lot of things that I didn't give away just because of the memories, and I wanted to have a few cute things that I kept, but like this was from a trade package. But I tried to consolidate, and like I had a lot more bins of these that had the plastic stuff in it before and the ceramic. So I've really tried to just cut down on the amount of stuff I've had. I'll show you guys the next bin now. Oh, I just realized that I called Victoria Rachel Chocolate Colors 26. I feel so embarrassed. Like I said, I'm just feeling really awkward and nervous at the moment. But yeah, she is now Victoria Rachel, of course, as you guys know. So this bin is a little bit random. I have a few smaller wooden houses that I was using for my dwarf hamsters. I also have some fun items like the swing. This was a gift that Fuzzy Polka Dot had sent to me, I think it was. This was a gift. So, like I said, all the gift things I'm keeping. I also have some hamster books in this tub that I didn't really have another place to put them, so I just put them in here. And then this last bin I have, again, a few more ceramic and plastic items like this I'm keeping just for photo shoots because they don't sell these anymore, so if I ever wanted a little TV, like, I'd never be able to find one anymore. So, yeah, I just kept a few things. So now I'm going to show you guys a few of the drawers that I kind of have organized, but they still look like they're a mess just because I can't fit everything in them. Okay, so over in this corner of my filming studio, I have some bins which have hamster bedding and like flying saucers and wheels and stuff. I did give a bunch of the wheels away that I don't plan to use anymore to the shelter because they have hamsters and stuff there that they get in. You can also see I have my hamster photos that I still have up to be able to see them, but maybe one day again I'll have like a specific hamster room to put them in. I don't know. Anyways, so this file cabinet here, this is where I'm storing all of my big hamster supplies that were in Kashi's cage, and they've all been sanitized and stuff. Oh, I have some more hamster photos in here. Like I said, it's kind of a mess in here, but this is just, I feel kind of embarrassed. This is really disorganized, but I just put a lot of the larger polyresin items in here. And let's take a look at the second drawer. I have no idea what we're getting into here. It's probably not very nice looking. yeah, I still have like the wood things and stuff. So, like I said, I'm just kind of storing this stuff for now, and I'll show you guys how I have my cage set up, but these are wonderful for storage. Otherwise, I'd have all these items all over the place that I wouldn't know where to put it, and it's just nice to have them tucked away at the moment. Okay, so on the other side of my room, I have another file cabinet that is storing more hamster supplies, and this is another one that I went through recently and tried to make more space in, so it's still not organized at all, but, you know. So this top one just has the larger wood things. Yeah, pretty much. I also have these, like, hamster magnets. They were supposed to go on my car, but I just decided to put them here because I can see them a lot more. So, and then I also have this one down here. So then in this drawer, this is one that I cleaned out pretty well. You can see there's a whole half of side that's empty, and that was a lot of stuff that I decided to give to the thrift store just because I didn't have plans to use it anymore, but the stuff I kept I probably will use again in future. And then, okay, this one has some more natural supplies that were in Kashi's cage. And then this last drawer here has a lot of stuff, and it's kind of messy, but hey, it all fits in. These are all my food dishes. I gave some of the food dishes away, but I have to admit I really love the cute shapes and stuff, so I decided to keep those ones. But yeah, as you guys can see, it's not like very organized, but it's at least I'm able to fit everything in there. So that was kind of my whole goal in cleaning these drawers out.
So this comment's from Victoria. She says, it's nice to see you haven't forgotten about your main channel. No, I promise I haven't. I love watching what you've been making on your second channel. Would you consider doing more collaborations in future? So I have done a couple of collaborations, I think, on my second channel, and I have done a couple on this channel as well. I don't have any collaboration plans for this channel unless like one of my friends like Victoria or somebody would reach out to me and say, hey, do you wanna, you know, do this type of video? I'd maybe consider it. But I do find collaborations to be a lot of work and a little bit stressful too, trying to coordinate the times that we're both like ready to have our video uploaded and making sure that we both have enough content in our video and it's kind of similar and just, I don't know, I get a little bit stressed doing collabs. I do better just like one on like doing my own video, so I like doing collaborations, but in another sense, they're a little bit stressful. So last question I'm gonna answer here is, can you do a life update or a morning night routine, a day in your life, vlog style? That's a video, like a morning night routine. That's something that I've wanted to do for so many years. I just haven't gotten to it. I just find it really overwhelming to think about, I guess. I don't know why. It's mostly setting up the camera and the lighting for every shot that just takes so long. But if I do post that type of video, it would be on my second channel. And I really want to do that in future, so hopefully that will be something that I can get to. Kind of like a day in my life, I guess. But I feel like it'd be more interesting if I had a pet, though. So, yeah, we'll see about that. But anyways, I think those are all the questions I'm going to answer for now. There were some other questions that were more like hamster care related, like what's your favorite hamster toy and that type of thing. I will try to go through and answer the ones I didn't answer in this video, but I'm going to go ahead and say bye for now. And if you guys would like to see, like I said, a more extravagant cage tour of the cage behind me, or the, not the cage, the garden, just let me know and I'll try to film that. And I have no idea when I'm going to post videos on this channel. It's not something that I'm doing steady anymore because I don't have a hamster. I don't feel like anybody's going to care about any videos unless they have a hamster in them. So, yeah, but I really enjoyed catching up with you guys. I hope you enjoyed listening to my video. And I hope you're doing great, even though it's been a crazy year, like I said. We're almost have a few more months left of the year, I guess, which is crazy. I don't know why it went by so fast, but we're getting into my favorite time of year, which is autumn and Christmas, and I just love it so much. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and end this here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I love you guys, and goodbye.